Adobe just introduced their new generative AI for video, and we need to talk about it because this is going to change Premiere Pro forever. I just got back from the Adobe Max conference, where Adobe showed off all of the new features that they're creating for all of their programs, including AI software for Photoshop and Adobe Illustrator, and this was cool, but as a filmmaker, I was hoping and waiting that they would show something for us video creators. Thankfully, they did not disappoint, and they are working on some really mind-blowing stuff. Let's start with Firefly Video AI. If you have any experience with generative AI, you've probably worked with something like Firefly, where you type into a text box and can either generate an image or modify an existing image. This Firefly Video AI system is similar to that in that Adobe showed off that you'll be able to type into a box and generate a video from a simple text prompt. The possibilities are really endless with something like this, but you do need to keep in mind that generating a video from text is significantly more complex than generating a simple image from text, because with video, you're not just generating one image, you're generating at least 24 images per second, which is definitely a lot more work and introduces a lot more opportunities for some sort of glitch to occur and the video to look weird. In Adobe's example, they used the text prompt, "A blue ocean surrounded by rocks," and this generated multiple video clips that resembled ocean waves crashing onto rocks on a seashore. It was rough, and the footage that it generated looks like it was lower resolution and a lower frame rate. But as we talk about this, I want you to remember that this is still version 1.0, and it's only going to improve and get better as time goes on. Now, here's where things get more mind-blowing and seem significantly more advanced, because this ocean waves example was not the only time that Adobe showed off generative AI for video, and their second example was significantly more impressive than the first. The second time they showed off this Firefly generative AI for video, it was during what they call Adobe Sneaks, where they show off a preview of projects that are a bit further off, but that their engineers are working on and that will hopefully be integrated into their software at some point in the future. This presentation started off in an interface that looked more like Photoshop, where there was a woman standing in front of a bridge and the presenter selected some distracting people in the background and used generative AI to remove them. Pretty standard, right? Well, the engineer then blew mine and everyone else's mind whenever they revealed that this was actually a video clip and that generative AI was removing the unwanted people throughout the entire clip. Now, I'm sure you're thinking, Matt, After Effects already has this feature. It's called Content Aware Fill, but I want you to know that this new Fast Fill feature is dramatically more advanced than Content Aware Fill, because the next example is something that I have never seen Content Aware Fill do. To start it off, the presenter had footage of a model walking toward the camera down a walkway while lighting conditions were constantly changing with the subject going in and out of sunlight and shadow. This model was in a suit but did not have a tie on, so the presenter selected the part of their shirt where a tie would have been, just like you would have selected something in Photoshop. Then, in the AI text prompt box, they typed tie, pressed fast fill, and in a few seconds, the generative AI had added a tie to this person's shirt, tracked it throughout the video clip, and then what was most impressive is that whenever the presenter hit play, the tie realistically stretched and moved like the rest of the fabric that the model was wearing would, and more importantly, the lighting of the tie matched with the lighting of the rest of the model. So as they went in and out of light and shadow, this generated footage of this tie matched the existing footage of the model essentially perfectly. This is just mind-blowing stuff, but I think about how many times I've wanted to remove something from a video clip or even add something in, and I've been unable to. But with this fill feature, it looks like it's now going to be possible. Now, we aren't done with video AI features yet, because another feature that Adobe announced they're working on is the ability for AI to generate a video from a still image. In their demo, Adobe showed a still image of an elephant, and then they used the Firefly Video AI model to animate this elephant and make it move in a realistic way. Of course, this was a very low frame rate video, and it resembled something like one of those Instagram boomerang videos that's moving forward and backwards, but my mind immediately went to how usable this technology would be even in its most basic early beta form. As a filmmaker, there have been many times where I've needed to show static images that were either photos of people or locations and then animate them in some way. I could either print out the images and then slowly pan my camera over them, which can look cool, or I could animate the digital images and have them slowly zoom in and out using Ken Burns style effects to make these images look more interesting as people watch my video. Well, with this Adobe Firefly for Video AI, imagine turning all of your images into videos. And instead of having to do some sort of slow pan or zoom, you could actually just have the entire video be video. Even the images. That would be far more interesting for your viewers to watch, and it's super cool. And I really think that we're just starting to scratch the surface of the possibilities that Firefly AI for Video is going to offer. Now, if you want a preview of where things are going, I would recommend looking at the work being done by projects like Runway ML, which seem to be a bit more advanced than Adobe right now in terms of AI video generation. But considering how much work and money Adobe is throwing at things, I can see them trying to catch up very quickly. Also, as another plus, I want you to consider that if you're a Creative Cloud subscriber, Adobe is most likely going to give you access to all of these AI tools with your subscription, which would be great. Of course, they could also decide to charge extra for this too, so keep that in mind. Regardless, we're not actually done with AI video features yet. There is a lot, isn't there? The next one is something called Project ResUp, and as the name implies, this is a tool that Adobe is working on that can upscale video files using AI. The most impressive part about this technology was that Adobe was working with very low resolution imagery, either zoomed in footage of a video or old footage that was much lower than HD. And then their AI was able to upscale this footage to HD and make it look significantly better. Of course, this was just a demo and I did not get to pixel peep any of this footage, so it remains to be seen exactly how high quality this upscaling technology is going to be. But considering that there are plugins like Topaz Video Enhance AI, or Blackmagic has a very good upscaler in DaVinci Resolve, it's great to see Adobe is working on AI upscaling technology as well. Regardless, we need to take a detour now and talk about audio. Yes, as a bonus, we need to talk about audio because Adobe showed off another project that they're working on, and this project has huge implications for you if you are a filmmaker that commonly finds yourself making videos for viewers around the world. This audio feature was called Project Dub, and it's essentially a way to dub any of your videos into a foreign language automatically using AI. You literally upload a video clip with audio being spoken, select the languages that you want your audio to be dubbed into, and then AI will translate your audio into these other languages while at the same time recreating your voice speaking these other languages. So when your audio is being dubbed, it does not sound like you hired another actor to dub you in another language. It sounds like it's your voice. This is really crazy, and I think about how many YouTubers out there, for example, have different channels for different languages, where they will have an English channel with them speaking in English, and then they'll have another channel where they're speaking in Spanish. This dub project could make that entire project much easier by using AI to dub your voice, but still keeping it your voice. It's so cool. So in short, I'm super excited about not only this Firefly audio AI, but video AI as well. Let me know in the comments below. Are you excited about this stuff too, or are you scared? Are you nervous about what's going on? Let me know. Also, because I would like to help you out with your filmmaking, I've created a free guide called Edit Videos Like a Pro. This guide is going to show you the most important and biggest things that I've learned over the years as a video editor, and I know they will help you. I would love for you to check it out. I will link to it down below. Thanks so much for watching, and have a great day.